Speeches, ubiquitous applause. The two meetings by China's top legislature and top advisory body have long been seen as rubber-stamped meetings, but China watchers say they're still an important barometer for the political mood.
For this NPC, I think the key area to pay attention to would be what signals are sent in terms of the leadership change. Now, this would be an indication of how Hu Jintao is doing in terms of placing some of his supporters in key positions. In terms of Wen Jiabao's in the work report, again, this will be an important part of trying to establish his legacy and that of Hu Jintao, and to look for any departures if there's any more serious discussion of political reform.
One reform that's being suggested is transforming China's state-led economic model to focus on the private sector. According to a new report titled China 2030 by the World Bank and a Chinese government think tank. For this year, in 2012, though, policies to quell public dissatisfaction are likely to remain at the top of the agenda, like affordable housing, tax cuts, and stamping out corruption.
From my point of view, I think the number one problem always is corruption, because corruption creates immediate and direct anger, like what you saw in Wuhan. And here I'm actually very pleased that they responded to Wuhan with a soft touch rather than bang, which was a traditional.
There could also be behind-the-scenes political jockeying, as some senior positions have yet to be filled.
There's lots of evidence of that jockeying underway. The recent excitement in Chengdu with the vice mayor of Chongqing, who is relieved of his responsibilities, and a face-off outside of the U.S. consulate. Now, this is a symbol or an example of the political pressures bubbling up to the surface.
For the outgoing administration, 2012 will be the last chance to leave a legacy of economic prosperity and social harmony. For the incoming leaders, the meetings will help cement their positions and set the scene for next year's power handover.